The book of Daniel is one of those seminal books, I think, of the Old Testament. And what I mean by that is it's the first book of apocalyptic material. It's one of the first books that actually begins to talk about God's redemptive plan going into the future, and future to the time of the people who actually received the book. We wouldn't be able to understand some of the material in Matthew and in Revelation without the book of Daniel. It is the most quoted book of the Old Testament in the New. And so it really sort of lays a great foundation for us, for our understanding of what God is doing for us presently, given what he was doing for them at that particular time. Because here's what the writer of Daniel knows. What he knows is when they went into exile, when Israel lost, when Jerusalem was destroyed, he knew what could potentially be destroyed was the faith of the people. We have always built our faith on the fact that God gave us this land and said he would preserve us in it despite how big the nations around us got. We are God's nation, and we're not going anywhere. And when the walls of Jerusalem came down, a whole lot of their faith did too. And the writer of Daniel knows it, and he says, yes, you got a problem, don't you, Israel? Listen, the vessels of your God is now in the house of his God. And they're probably struggling with, okay, listen, is our God a tribal God, or is he really the one and only God? And it doesn't look like he is anymore, because the world is changing, and it looks like, well, maybe our faith has been primitive. Maybe we need a more global faith. Maybe we need a better religion, a religion that takes modern realities into account. So Daniel gets at the heart of what's bugging them. He says deliberately, the things of your God is now in the house of his God. But listen, you need to know, it was God who gave you into his hands, and he knows they're probably struggling with it, because listen, that's not how we think. That's not been our faith. Our God doesn't give us into anybody else's hands. And listen, when I read it, my first struggle was, okay, I don't want to believe a fool's gold faith either. I don't want to look back at history and be blind to the reality that, listen, God, my God, had always worked in this little bitty nation, and when realities changed, we had to start thinking differently. The writings of the book of Moses, which was historically written long before this happened or was written. Y'all say it with me, this is important. The same God that we worshiped and that Israel worshiped told the nation in its infancy, if you break my covenant, I will bring a nation who will consume you. In other words, their faith wasn't in his word anyway. Their faith was in who they wanted him to be. Their faith is in what they thought he would do and not what he said he would do. See, our tendency is to reevaluate God, to redefine him according to what we want him to be. And we forget he has already spoken through his word who he is and what he will do. They're reshaping God in their own image. Listen, he already told you what he would do. Just because you don't like what he would do doesn't mean you get to say that's not him. That's why we have all, as a community of faith, agreed that this is a revelation of him. Listen, if he told the nation generations ago, if you break my covenant, I'm going to send a nation to consume you. When it happened, why do you have a faith problem?